for technical and financial competence and ability to raise finance. That's the short summary. What else would you want from a core investor in any business? Technical skills, financial ability, sound financially, and ability to raise finance to do the business. That was a nutshell. And like I explained earlier, to carry out this evaluation, we had the team. We actually went outside the traditional approach of just relying on the government agency in charge, the BPE, because we had the confidence that we wanted a transparent process. We chose evaluators out of six institutions, the BPE itself, NERC, the regulator, the third one from Nigeria was the Ministry of Power. And then on the side of, then we also had three foreign companies, CPCS, Transcom, who were the advisor on the transaction, Nexant of the USA, and then NIAF, NIAF, who are DFID financed from the UK. So these people did the evaluation. The evaluation was reviewed by two different committees before it got to the NCP. So that, I mean, I think that's an extent to which this so-called controversy is arising after the game has been played.
Can you speak to the possibility of any changes to the announced preferred bidders post-NCP sitting by the end of this month?
Unless you are saying that the NCP or anybody is a complete rubber stamp, in which case I will just sort of hand you the stamp now, you just rubber stamp it. Of course, there will be, sometimes there are gray areas even. Sometimes there's black, there's white, and there's gray. I imagine that we can easily agree on what is black, agree on what is white. It's the gray areas that you focus on usually. That is what all meetings are about usually, not the extremes, which are pretty clear.
The three governors have said that they will not allow Vigiemin, the winner of the Benin distribution company, to operate. What is NCP doing about this?
One thing you should bear in mind is that I raised some questions, during the press conference. One of the questions I raised was the fact that all these consortia are private sector controlled. The Southern Consortium, which those three governors say they favored, from the records before us, are 90%, roughly 90% private sector interests. You follow me? So now, the governors did not complete, and the ones that physically filled out the form. They are minor shareholders, their governments in that company. Somebody in the private sector took responsibility for preparing the bids for Southern Consortium. Did that person tell the governors the truth and the whole truth? Did that person tell the governors that he breached, he flouted the regulations? I don't know. You have to ask the governors. It's possible that the governors may come back and say, oh my God, we were not informed by this fellow that he broke the rules. It's even possible that somebody breaks a rule, runs to the governors to go and scream murder because he knows that he himself is in trouble. I don't know. The second point I raised was that, is it correct to seek to rewrite the rules after a game has been played? These rules were advertised 2 years ago. Nobody complained. Bidders were called to conferences. We took feedback. We tried to dot I's and cross T's, fine-tune them. They all agreed to take part based on these rules. It's only when some people think that somebody else might win that they begin to question the rules. Is that correct? And the third point I raised is about fairness. Even if governors or any other group who think they are directly or indirectly involved in a consortium bidding believe that the process, they're not happy with something, what is wrong with picking up your phone and calling the chairman of the NCP?